Good morning. Sounds like this is the fellowship hour. Sounds like you're all visiting really well. That's great to see you all here on this beautiful morning. Anybody up for the sunrise this morning? It was absolutely beautiful. Good to be into the summer months and the beautiful weather, and it's just great to be here. Pastor Beth is on vacation this week, so Bruce and I are in charge, right? For today, anyways. But that means that the brunch with Beth on Thursday is not going to happen. So that's one of the announcements I had. A couple other announcements. We are starting to collect rummage items, and that is a list in the bulletin there of what is needed for the rummage sale taking place in the fall, I believe, right? Or late summer?
August.
Okay, close enough. If you ordered any Lord of Life apparel, clothing, that is in the office. I can help you with that after the service, or you can look for the bag with your name on it on the back counter in the church office. Other announcements are listed for us in the bulletin. It is Trinity Sunday, right? You all knew that on your way here to church, right? Okay, good. Big festival day in the church. Last week was Pentecost. I heard everything really went well here while we were at assembly. It was wonderful to be together with so many others in worship in Minot, but it was also wonderful to hear that there was a good crowd here, and we all got to see and hear the same sermon from our bishop. How neat is that? Those are the announcements for today. Please stand as we begin our worship today. Take a moment of silence and then continue with our confession and forgiveness. Let us begin. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open and all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive us all our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us confess. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare unto you the forgiveness of all your sins in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us join together in our opening hymn, Come Join the Dance of Trinity.
Speak aloud.
Of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty Creator and ever-living God, we worship your glory, eternal three in one, and we praise your power, majestic one in three. Keep us steadfast in this faith. Defend us in all adversity. Bring us at last into your presence, where you live in endless joy and love. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Please be seated for the readings.
Our first reading is taken from Proverbs, the 8th chapter. Does not wisdom call, and does not understanding raise her voice? On the heights, beside the way, at the crossroads, she takes her stand. By the gates, beside the gates in front of the town, and at the entrance of the portal, she cries out, "To you, O people, I call, and my cry is to all that live." The Lord created me at the beginning of his work, the first of his acts of long ago. Ages ago, I was set up, at the first, before the beginning of the earth. When there were no depths, I was brought forth. When there were no springs abounding with water. Before the mountains had been shaped, before the hills, I was brought forth. When he had not yet made earth and fields, or the world's first bits of soil. When he established the heavens, I was there. When he drew a circle on the face of the deep. When he made firm the skies above. When he established the fountains of the deep. When he assigned to the sea its limit, so that the waters might not transgress his command. When he marked out the foundations of the earth, then I was beside him, like a master worker, and I was daily his delight, rejoicing before him always, rejoicing in his inhabited world, and delighting in the human race. Thanks be to God. Please read with me, responsively, Psalm 8. O Lord, our Sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, and that you have established, yet you have made them a little lower than God and crowned them with glory and honor. All sheep and oxen, and also the beasts of the field.
The birds of the air, the fish of the sea, whatever passes along the paths of the seas.
O Lord, our Sovereign, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Our second reading is taken from Romans, the 5th chapter. Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. And not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. Thanks be to God.
I would invite a few of the kids, or all the kids, to come up for a children's message. It's going to be on the Trinity. We're going to recite together the Athanasian Creed. Those of you who know the Athanasian Creed get that, right? We'll talk about that later. Well, good morning. Good morning. Isn't it a beautiful day? Who created this day for us? Didn't God, right? Right? Today we're talking about God, and God as the Creator, God the Father, Jesus, His Son, and the Holy Spirit, which is probably the one that we struggle the most with, maybe. But that's the Trinity. Today is Trinity Sunday, and we're celebrating this God that we know as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So I have a real simple way to maybe kind of help with that as much as I can. What's your name? Devin. Okay, I'm going to pick on you, Devin. How old are you, Devin?
10.
You are 10. So you are your mom and dad's son, right? Okay, but you're also, you have a sibling, you have a brother or a sister?
I have both.
You have both. Lucky you, there's three of you, right? Well, so Devin, you're Devin, right? You're Devin as Devin, but then you're also Devin as son of your mom and dad, right? So how can you be both? Because you are, exactly. Perfect answer. Oh, is that my phone? My microphone? Oh, it is mine. Okay, so Devin, you're both Devin, and you're both son of mom and dad. But then you're also a brother to these siblings, right? So how can you be all three of those things? Because you are. So the answer to the question is, like, how can God be Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is because God is. Right, exactly. That's probably the best answer I could ask for. We think of God as one God, but in three different expressions, just like you are both son, brother, and you're just yourself as Devin, right? God's the way God created you. So thanks for letting me pick on you, Devin. We celebrate God. God's a mystery, but it's something that we just are, and that's kind of points to the fact that God is also mystery. We can't figure out everything in this world, children. I hope you can learn that. Everybody else out here is trying to learn that too. We can't figure everything else out, and we can't figure everything out in words or in pictures or even in pages of books. We just believe God is what God is, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And that's helpful for us because God loves us in all three of those expressions. We're like three times loved over, and the Spirit is always with us. So let's pray. You pray after, repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for mystery. Thank you for loving us. As Creator, as Redeemer, and as the Spirit. Amen. Thanks for coming up, you guys. Great job. Reed, am I doing something to this to make it do what it's doing? I would invite you all to please stand as you are able for the reading of our gospel. Our gospel for today is from John's gospel, the 16th chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth, for he will not speak of his own, but will speak whatever he hears, and he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, because he will take what is mine and declare it to you. All that the Father has is mine, and for this reason I said that he will take what is mine and declare it to you. Please be seated. Grace and peace to all of you today on Trinity Sunday. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give thanks for beautiful summer mornings, for the creation that cries out your love and beauty, your holiness, your mystery, for your Son Jesus, who came that we might know your love in a way that can only be expressed as one human being to another, and from the Spirit who continues to live and move in each of us, revealing your grace, your love, and your peace. Amen. Well, it is Trinity Sunday, and we are celebrating God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one in three, eternal three in one, majestic, eternal, and mysterious. In many churches today, and maybe even this one previously, do you remember the creed that you used to recite regularly? The Nicene Creed? We believe in one God. I'm not going to recite the whole thing. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in the one Lord Jesus, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not one, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father through whom all things were made. Or how many of you remember the Athanasian Creed? That, you know, the Nicene Creed was 381, right? That's in the time of Constantine. A little bit of an older creed, right? But we have a newer creed, the Athanasian Creed. That was 1642. That's the new one. And in that one, we hear words like, we worship one God in Trinity and the Trinity in unity, neither confusing the persons nor dividing the divine being. For the Father is one person, the Son is one person, the Spirit is still another, but the deity of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit is one, equal in glory and co-eternal in majesty. Can you imagine having to memorize that before your pastor, right? The Athanasian Creed. All creeds are at best, descriptions of the way in which we experience God in our world today. And all creeds are written to describe what God is and often what God is not. All creeds are attempts to put words into what we believe about the God we worship. Our best efforts are to give words to our experience of God in our life and in the lives of others. So how do you describe God as Trinity? Words, so many words, right? And then there are pictures or images that we have used throughout history. So there's a few of them there. How do we put into words how we understand God as creator, as redeemer, as sanctifier? It is a mystery. St. Augustine, the bishop of Hippo in the 4th century, about the time the Nicene Creed was developed, was once walking along the sea, the Mediterranean Sea, contemplating the idea of the Trinity. And he noticed a young child running back and forth from the sea with a bucket, grabbing a bucket of water and then dumping it into a hole that she had dug. So Augustine stopped and asked the child what she was doing. She said very happily, "Oh, I am putting the giant sea into my little hole." And Augustine then dawned upon himself that that is exactly what we are trying to do when we are trying to understand the great notion of the identity of God, in putting it into our tiny little brains. We are a people who like answers, right? We like information. And when we have a question in our culture, where do you go for the answer? Yeah, an encyclopedia, right? Google, right? I mean, anytime you want to learn something or know something, we are just obsessed with this information. We grab our phones and start Googling it. Whether it's information or misinformation, we want to gobble it up. We're obsessed with answers. When there's a problem in my life or something I need to fix, I go right to YouTube and see if someone's fixed it before me and learn from that, right? We are an information culture. We are far more comfortable with information than we are with mystery. Mystery is not what we want in this life, most of us anyways. We'd rather have a clear answer. Just the facts, ma'am. Yet God is mystery, and we want to reduce the vast sea of God into our tiny little bucket of brains. We create constructs, systematic theologies and doctrines to reduce the God of creation to a three-point statement. Yet our hearts are longing to experience and connect with this God of mystery. Jesus said, "I still have many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. For he will not speak on his own, but he will speak whatever he hears and will declare to you the things that are to come." Jesus himself spoke and proclaimed the mystery of God and our limitation and understanding for bearing it all at once. And still, Christ came to proclaim the Spirit that will come and guide us into truth. So here's what I hope to convey to you on this amazing Trinity Sunday. God is mystery. God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier. One in three, eternal three in one. God is mystery. And the Trinity is not so difficult a mystery that we cannot seek to describe it as we should for all, like all the believers before us, but we must express it in how we experience God. Above all, the creeds and images and doctrines of Trinity, it is all about relationship. What I didn't say to the children but can say to you is that we are all related in partnerships and relationships. And God is that way. For God is Father to Son, Son to Spirit, an intimately connected, separate yet one, distinct yet unified. The Trinity is a divine dance, a dance that creates and redeems and sustains the whole of all creation. The Trinity, the dance of the Trinity, as we sang it in our opening hymn, is not exclusive and far off in some distant heaven. The Trinity invites us to join in. The Apostle Paul said in our reading today that we have access to grace through Christ. Such is the nature of the Trinity that it includes all of creation in the dance. The very core and nature of God is collaborative. Let me repeat that. The very core and nature of God is to collaborate, and not just with the Trinity among itself, but with us included. We need not search any further than our very own heartbeat and breath to realize that God is with us. Take a deep breath with me. Breathe in and hold it, and then breathe out. The Spirit of God is in you and in me and in all of creation. God as Creator loves the creation. Christ the Redeemer walks with us, revealing the eternal truth of this love, belonging, grace, and acceptance. The Spirit continues to reveal God to us and all around us. And the longing in your heart to know God is a longing to dance with the Trinity. We dance when we care for the creation, nurturing the life around us, as farmers and gardeners know this best. We dance the dance of the Trinity when we look to Jesus Christ, who loves us and came to be among us and loved us as only another human can, walking alongside our neighbors, caring and loving for them. We walk and dance with them as Christ loved us. We dance when we restore broken relationships, giving and receiving forgiveness, having access to God's grace for all, raising to life that which was dead in sin to live again, beautiful and transformed. We dance the dance of the Trinity as we learn the mysteries in this life, the messy and complicated mysteries that are yet ever so beautiful, we call it holy. We dance the dance of the Trinity, leaning into or allowing the Spirit to guide us as Jesus prayed. And we discover that the messy and complicated is indeed holy. We dance, leaning, allowing the Spirit to transform us. So let us dance. Dance the dance of the Trinity and discover the mystery of God, the wonder of God's love for all of us, each of us, and Christ who embodied that love and the Spirit who dwells in all of us. Let's dance. Amen. Please join in our hymn of the day. We're using some of those traditional favorite hymns. And today's hymn, Holy, 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 was written by the Anglican bishop, Ronald Heber. Heber is careful to describe the celebrating the mystery of the Trinity, and though we may not see or completely understand the Trinity in its fullness and lifetime, Heber, along with Dykes, who wrote the tune, collaboration reminds us that there are reminds us of those who are not the reasons to preclude us from worshiping the Trinity. He wrote this hymn to be sung on Trinity Sunday, right between the sermon and the Apostles' Creed, or right between the sermon and the creed. So let's stand and let's sing, "Holy, Holy, Holy." Trinity Sunday, we're going to use a different statement of faith rather than the Apostles' Creed, the Athanasian Creed. This is a creed that was put together in the 80s by the Presbyterian Church, USA, and we will be using it today. So please join in. If you want more information on that, there's a packet at the back table about the development of this statement of faith, but it is a wonderful statement that brings out the journey of God's love for all people through Christ and through all of us. So let us join together. In life and in death, we belong to God. Through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit, we trust in the one triune God, Holy One of Israel, whom alone we worship and serve. We trust in Jesus Christ, fully human, fully God. Jesus proclaimed the reign of God, preaching the good news to the poor and the release to the captives, touching by word and deed, and blessing the children, healing the sick, binding up the brokenhearted, eating with outcasts, forgiving sinners, and calling all to repent and believe in the gospel. Unjustly condemned for blasphemy and sedition, Jesus was crucified, suffered the depths of human pain, giving his life for the sins of the world. God raised Jesus from the dead, vindicating his sinless life, breaking the power of sin and evil, delivering us from the death to eternal life. We trust in God, whom Jesus called Abba, Father. In sovereign love, God created the world good and makes everyone equal in God's image. male and female, of every race and people, to live as one community. But we rebel against God. We hide from our Creator, ignoring God's commandments. We violate the image of God in others and ourselves, accept lies as truth, exploit neighbor and nature, and threaten death to the planted entrusted to our care. In ever. To redeem creation in everlasting love. The God of Abraham and Sarah chose a covenant people to bless all families of the earth. Hearing their cry, God delivered the children of Israel from a house of bondage. Loving us still, God makes us heirs with Christ the covenant. Like a mother who will not forsake her nursing child, like a father who runs to welcome the prodigal home, God is faithful still. We trust in the God of the Holy Spirit, everywhere the giver and renewer of life. The Spirit justifies by grace and sees free to accept ourselves and to love God and neighbor, and blinds us together with all believers. In the one body of Christ, the Church, the same Spirit who inspired the prophets and apostles rules our faith and life in Christ through Scripture, engages us through word proclaim, claims us in the waters of baptism, feeds us with the bread of life in the cup of salvation, and calls men and women to be ministers of the Church. In a broken and fearful world, the Spirit encourages us to witness among all peoples to Christ as long Savior, to unmask idolatries in church and culture, to hear the voices of people long silence, and to work for others for justice, freedom, and peace. In gratitude to God, empowered by the Spirit, we strive to serve Christ in our daily tasks and to live holy and joyful lives, even as we watch for God's good new heaven and new earth, praying, come, Lord Jesus. With every means in time and place, we rejoice that nothing in life or death can separate us from the love of God in Jesus our Lord. Glory be to God, the Father, and the Spirit, and to this Spirit. We continue with the prayers of the people. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs.
Holy God.
Sorry. Holy God, we praise your name. Help us to joyfully proclaim it to the world and to honor it in all we do. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Gracious Father, bless and preserve your holy church, purchased with the blood of your dear Son and sanctified with the fire of your Spirit. Keep it steadfast in faith, sound in doctrine, loving in service, generous in giving, ardent in worship, and holy in living. In all things, make your church a lamp filled with the light of your presence, welcoming and guiding many to salvation in your holy name. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Jesus, we pray for all students, especially those graduating this spring. Guide them in paths of wisdom and righteousness in whatever they do. Teach them to love goodness, truth, and beauty, which spring from your very heart. Bless them and their families, teachers, mentors, and friends who encouraged and supported them along the way. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, we pray for all affected by recent violence in our country and elsewhere. Give us the courage to address the root causes of such events with focus, compassion, and love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Jesus, we ask that you be with and watch over Pastor Beth on her vacation, that her travels be safe and her time away refreshing. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Lord, gather all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Visit them with your salvation. Support them and all who love them with your holy and life-giving spirit. We especially pray today for all those on our prayer list as listed in the bulletin, and for those spoken aloud here or held in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ our Lord. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Please turn and share a sign of peace with your neighbor. Seated, our offerings, we give thanks for the many offerings and blessings that you give to us. We'll receive those offerings and join in our singing of the offertory. Please rise for the singing of our offertory.
Please pray with me. Blessed are you, Lord our God,
maker of all things.
Through your kindness
have blessed us with these gifts. With them we offer ourselves to your service and dedicate our lives to the care and redemption
of all that you have made.
For the sake of him who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and grace.
It is our duty, our right, and our joy that we should at all times and in all places offer our praise and thanks to you, Almighty and merciful God, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. You reveal your glory to us in the glory of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, equal in majesty, undivided in splendor, one Lord, one God, ever to be adored in your eternal glory. And so, with the choirs of angels the church on earth, and the hosts of heaven. We praise your name and join their unending hymn. The night in which he was betrayed, our Lord took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after the supper, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, given and shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of your sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered around this open table, we pray together as our Lord has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. You may be seated. Please note, all are welcome at this table of the Lord. Children are welcome to receive at any age as well. Please note that today we are going to move into a use of intinction, that is the dipping of the wafer into the chalice. We have two chalices, one of wine, that is the darker, one of grape juice, that is the lighter. The server will have both. Please, those of you who have children, please help them with the intinction since it is new, or maybe new for them. But we will commune today starting with this side, one station at the center, Judy and I, and then the second side will do this side second. Okay? All are welcome and all is ready. So let us dine. And as you are able for the communion blessing. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you provide the true bread from heaven, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant that we who have received the sacrament of his body and blood may abide in him and he in us, that we may be filled with the power of his endless life, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you, now and forever.
Amen.
Please note that there is the festivities continue. There is coffee and treats for those who'd like to stay. Please join us in the fellowship hall. If not, have a blessed day.
Peace. Serve the Lord.